Why are there holes in my kale? And what should I do about it? Is this stuff even edible anymore? I'm so scared of these holes in my kale. I hear this so much from so many of you, and so in today's video, we're gonna talk about holy kale and what you should do about it. Hey there, my name is Nicole Burke, and I'm the owner and founder of Gardenary. Gardenary exists to make gardening ordinary. So if you would like tips and tricks and all kinds of instruction and help to make gardening an ordinary part of your life, we would love it if you would subscribe to the Gardenary channel and tell all your friends about it. As soon as you subscribe, you can email hello@gardenary.com and let us know you've done so. Give us a little screenshot of your subscription and we will hook you up with a free gardening resource. Now let's talk about holy kale. I have been harvesting from my kale plants. I do it every day and I often share, say on Instagram, my harvest. And whenever people recently saw all these holes in my kale, they were like, oh my gosh, what are you gonna do about those holes? I have holes too, and what should I do about these holes? And I'm like, it's okay, don't worry, I got you. So in today's video, I wanna address it, what we should do with these holes, where they come from, is this stuff even edible anymore, and more. So first of all, let's talk about where the holes come from. Generally speaking, well, these could come from any kind of pest, something, some kind of animal besides you is eating from this plant, right? In general, if you have munchy holes on the side of your leaf, like this one, then this means it's some kind of plant that's coming at your leaf from the outside, right? But if you have holes on the interior of your leaf, then that generally means you have some kind of pest that's coming at your plant from the underside. It's usually living and crawling and eating holes into the leaves. In general, probably 9 times out of 10. Now I've had other things eat my kale, like slugs and snails and you know, birds even. I had a set of birds 2 years ago that they just ate the kale every day. It was the weirdest thing. But 9 times out of 10, it's gonna be caterpillars. Caterpillars love to eat leafy greens. They feast on them, and that helps them grow and turn into moths, or generally not butterflies. Generally, they're gonna turn into some kind of cabbage moth or something. Most of the time, when I have holes on the underside, inside my kale leaves or any kind of brassica plant, I can eventually start to find little bitty tiny caterpillars or even bigger ones that are crawling around on my leaves. So that's where it comes from. It's some kind of pest, some kind of animal that's not you that's eating your plant. Rarely when you have a very healthy, nice green leaf like this with no yellowing, no, you know, spotting or anything, and you've just got holes, that is rarely disease. It's almost always pests. So that's the good news. Disease is harder to treat, harder to deal with. Pests, I find, are not that big of a deal because I'm like, I'm an animal too. I can deal with animals. But you can see even on this kale leaf, right? Like the top was eaten by a bigger pest. Something came and munched the sides of it, but then a smaller pest put holes into the leaves themselves. So for me personally, this is not a big deal. I shared on one of my podcasts last year a story of when I first started gardening. I was heading to the farmer's market in Nashville almost every week with my kids. And I bought this corn one day. It was like middle of July. So delicious, but I peeled it back and there were all these little worms like at the top of the corn. It grossed me out. I was like, ah, gross. It was like my first exposure to farmer's market corn and it was gross. So, but we cut that off and ate the rest of the corn. It was actually really delicious. So next week we go back to the farmer's market. I go back to the lady at the same spot, right? And I'm like, hey, you know, your corn was delicious, but it had all these, you know, caterpillars at the top of it. It's kind of gross. Like, can you help me make sure I get corn that doesn't have that? And she said, honey, if the worms don't like to eat that, if the caterpillars don't like it, it ain't no good. And I was like, oh, okay. So one way to think about it. So instead of seeing it as, ooh, gross, some animal besides me is eating my plants, it's kind of like, oh, good. That means it's good, right? Like, there's nothing on here that tells an animal, this is disgusting, this is not good for me, or this is synthetic or not real, right? Animals are coming upon these plants and saying, wow, organic, delicious food, let's have some. So there's two ways you can see this, and I like to see it with a glass that's half full. So I see it as, I've got some delicious kale here, I've got tons of it, so I can share a little bit with the other animals that might happen upon my garden. Now, I don't wanna share all of it, so I'm not gonna, you know, just let them have at it, but I'm also not going to stress out about it. So that's where the holes come from. If there's no other sign of discoloration or change in the structure of your leaves, it's usually not disease, it is pests. So what can we do about it? Number one, we've already addressed, is not to stress. To see it as a good sign, you have an organic, natural, flourishing garden, and other animals who live alongside you are finding that to be true, and they're just kind of eating right next to you. The next thing I always do is I prune. So as soon as I start to see leaves with holes, the next time I come into the garden, I'm gonna come with my pruners, and almost as much as possible, I'm gonna prune and cut away the leaves that have the holes in it. 9 times out of 10, not always, but a lot of times the pest is on the leaf or somewhere nearby. So by getting rid of the leaves with the holes in them, I really, you know, kind of up my chance of getting the pest too. So I just come in, and any leaf that I see that's got holes, you can see this one's being eaten like this, then I pull it off. Now you can see these newer leaves that are coming from the center of the plant, they don't have any holes at all, right? So the pests have not come to those yet. The pests are really focusing on the bigger leaves. So when I take these leaves with the holes in them, I'm hopefully removing any cocoons. There might be cocoons underneath these leaves where pests are living, but also hopefully I'm removing some of the microscopic pests that may be there. So that's step one, is to prune. I like to do this, you know, pretty much regularly. And honestly, like I said, I'm not scared of, there's nothing wrong with these leaves. In fact, there's something even better about it. I'll tell you about in a second. There's nothing wrong with these leaves, so I just prioritize eating the ones that have the holes in them. So try to get rid of the pests by pruning and then eating those first and letting the newer leaves stay. So that's step one, is to harvest and prune the things that have holes in them. The next thing that I do is I clean the bottom of the garden area. So I clean the soil area. So I'll come down to where, and I don't have a rake with me, but I'll come down, say underneath the plant, and I'll just kind of check it. So that is not a caterpillar, but what I would want to do is come down and just kind of clean out around the base of the plant. Oftentimes, caterpillars will hide under the base of the plant when it's warm and hot, and then they will come out when it's dark. So, you know, just checking, kind of cleaning around the base of the plant is a huge step. So I try to make sure there's no weeds there, there's no, you know, debris, there's no leaves for them to hide in, all these kind of things. We get a lot of tree debris right underneath our plants. And a lot of people ask me about mulching the garden, and this is one of the reasons why I do not recommend putting wood mulch in your garden. It's because it really literally gives all the pests a place to hide. And that's the last thing I wanna do. So I could do this much more thoroughly, can get my little garden rake and just kind of clean the area right underneath the plant. So I didn't turn up any pests by doing this, but sometimes I do, you never know. And then you can kind of just check the stem of the plant, so I can just, you know, kind of check out the stem of this plant, see if I see any pests living on the stem itself. And I don't. So these guys are either just doing a really good job of hiding, or I just can't see them. But I'm just gonna clean and check the plant for any extra pests. At this point too, you can take a hose, a garden hose, and spray the plant really well. This works super well if you've got an aphid infestation or any smaller pests. So you can just spray the plant pretty hard with a good bit of water, and that will hopefully sometimes can kind of dispel whatever pest is hanging out there. Then what I'll do at this point is honestly just let it be. So I might add a little bit of compost around the bottom of the plant, not any kind of fertilizer, but something to support the plant as it's fighting off the pest and dealing with the pest. So I might add a little bit of fresh compost just right around the base of this plant. Then I'm just gonna probably let it be. What I could do in this case is cover it. That's another option. I'll show you what I'll use for that. So I have, you know, my mesh that I love to use, my garden mesh. And this would be a great time if I wanted to, if I was having a lot of issues and the pest pressure was getting pretty heavy, I could take this mesh and cover it. Now, I would only want to do that if I knew I had removed the pest, right? Because if I have not removed the pest, this is generally a better thing to do from the outset, because if I haven't gotten the pest out of here, then I'm literally giving them a trap where they can stay inside, feast, and no predator is going to come in and eat them, right? So this is actually, the cover is really a better thing to do at the outset to prevent pests rather than to treat, but that is an option. What I would instead hope for in this situation is to have birds coming into the garden space, right? Because birds like to eat worms and caterpillars. So if I make sure that this is open to birds, I could even add a bird feeder or a bird bath. It's a great way to welcome birds to come into the garden and to help me fight these pests. And then finally, let's say I leave the plant, I'll come in and check on it every, say, 3 to 5 days. If I see the infestation continue to get worse, and after I try this treatment, say 1 or 2 times, I may eventually decide just to pull the plant altogether. If I think it's just kind of a harbor for pests, then I may pull it all together. But in general, I'll tell you, it's very rare that I have to do this. Now, there are organic ways you can deal with pests. You know, you can spray castile soap. There's a lot of organic sprays you could put on the leaves. But I have to tell you, I so rarely do that. I generally deal with pests just with this little step where I just prune. Well, first I don't stress, then I prune, clean the soil, add compost, and then either cover or welcome predators into the garden space. And that generally keeps my garden fairly healthy. Now, is it pest-free? Absolutely not. But just like that lady told me at the farmer's market, I shouldn't expect it to be, right? If I'm growing delicious organic food, of course, other animals are going to want to come and eat it from it. Now, final thought to leave with you is that pests affected plants are actually not worse for you, but better for you. Wait, what? That's crazy, right? So many times people are like, can I still eat it? It's got holes in it. And I'm like, oh, that's definitely the kind of leaf you want to eat from. And let me tell you why. When plants are attacked by a pest like these, when this kale gets holes in its leaves, it automatically begins producing new antioxidants, new hormones, new nutrients for its plant, for itself, to fight off the pests. So it may be changing its flavoring to deter the pests. It may be just growing its muscles, its antioxidants, so that it can keep growing even though it's losing, you know, parts of its leaf matter. It's doing all kinds of things internally to keep itself alive. So many times we think that our plants want to die and we want them to live. So it's a struggle. But actually, our plants want to live more than we want them to. They want to live so much that they want to grow and become many, many more versions of themselves. And so the beautiful thing to know about, anytime you see pests on your leaves or any pest infestation, that means your leaves are going to give you that much more nutrients, that much more vitamins. They're that much more better for you to eat than the stuff that looks perfect and has no holes at the grocery store. So I hope this encourages you. One, don't stress about the holes. It's not a big deal. It's a sign that your garden is healthy and organic, and it's a sign that you should be eating from your garden faster than the rest of the animals. That's what I always take it as a clue for. When I see that there's holes and munching on my plants, I say, oh my gosh, they beat me to it and I grew it for myself. So I better get out there and harvest and start eating faster than they do. So be encouraged, holes in your leaves, pests on your plants, it's often a sign that you're doing everything right. So don't stress out, prune, clean, give your plants the nutrients they need to fight off those predators, and then eat it up, holes and all, because this is a sign that your plant is even better for you with the holes in it. Cheers. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.